Now, let me advise you, if you have very young children in your house, try not to drink coffee in front of them. Huh? Don't encourage them to drink. You know, children below 12, if they become addicted to coffee, below 12, children, those become addicted to coffee, they already have an addiction problem, in this case to caffeine. When children have an addiction to caffeine, they have an addiction. Now, research has shown you can move from one addiction to another addiction easily. So if you have a caffeine addiction, you can easily move to nicotine, you can move to alcohol, and maybe you can move to drugs and so on, right? So do not encourage coffee in your house, especially if you have very young children, right? Now, why am I saying this? Now, there has been suggestions, if you go and if you look at the literature, it says that people who are addicted to gaming, addiction to gaming, they may be vulnerable to other addictions also, because they have an addiction problem. She was a rebellious teenager, decided to leave home after an argument with her father. And she usually spent the night at internet cafes or public bathhouses, you know, the toilets and bathrooms. She supported herself by playing games at internet cafes. She supported herself. How? She was particularly good with an online game called Crossfire. She was very good with Crossfire. So other gamers would pay her to play the game for them. And children feel strong emotions for their pets. They name their pets. They feed and play with them. They build homes for them. They go for holidays with them. They go for virtual adventures with them. And they've got these meters. They can obsessively monitor the health condition of their pets, the emotional level, psychological level. And the children have to keep on logging. Yeah? If they don't visit the pets can fall sick, go into grief and die. You know? So the children have to keep on logging on, right, to keep the pet happy. Now, how do they manipulate children? In the free mode, like all games, free play in basic mode, they're given free virtual cash accessories on registration, and then they threaten children. If you stop visiting the pet, your pet will die, alright? Or you can't visit anymore. Huh? So they exploit later with the sales of virtual goods, subscriptions, and of course, advertising spins. Huh? It is enticing. For example, like, you know why we read all these horror stories? We like all these horror movies? Because it's unpredictable. When something is unpredictable, we get a dopamine release and then we have pleasure.
Situation with the fastest internet access in the world. It's even got online gamers who are national celebrities and earn six-figure salaries. But at a time when professional gaming is receiving international attention, so is the topic of gaming addiction. The problem has grown so big, the Korean government has injected millions into helping addicts.
몇 년은 아니고 한 세네 달 동안 겨우 끌어당기는 것 같이 자꾸 이렇게 근데 하면서 이제 문득 잠자라고 누우면서 어떤 허망함, 공허함 내가 지금 왜 이렇게 살...
Okay. Now, this gaming addiction is real. Huh? It's real because of two chemicals that are produced in the brain, dopamine and oxytocin. Two chemicals. Huh? Now, dopamine is a chemical that helps the brain experience pleasure, reward and pleasure. Without dopamine, you will not feel pleasure. Those people who have very low levels of dopamine get bored very quickly. They are the ones who are at risk of playing, of lumba haram and... Okay, we know about this? Yeah, we know. Huh? You can actually get a virtual pet. You don't need to get a dog or a cat anymore. Don't waste your time. Difficult, huh? Real dog or poola and all that. This one got no poo to handle. Huh? Very easy, very clean. Huh? We have virtual pet website. You're fighting with another group online in real time. And there are problems arising from this. Some of the problems, conflict with parents. Parents don't understand. They see this as wasting time. They have no idea why you need to play in the middle of the night, why you need to play for so many hours. And there's always conflict over the computer. There's a family computer. Now, game culture disregards age differences. Now, in game culture, you can be a 10-year-old and you can be very famous, well-known. And you have adults who are dependent on you because your character has reached a certain stage. You're very useful, very powerful. You have certain assets, certain abilities. And To cater for this, you have this massively multiplayer online role-playing games. These are the ones that we're actually talking about. Very popular from too many people taking part at the same time. That is, we can be in different places. We have a computer, we have a character, and then all our characters can meet online, and then we can be part of a team. Now, we become social communities carrying out different tasks together. Again, biological reasons. Our species cannot survive alone. We need to live in a group. So we are encouraged to be together, to bond. So this chemical is released, makes us feel good each time we are close to someone. Now, the same chemical is released during gaming, especially when you play big groups in guilds. These role-playing games, you're in a group, you feel, and this chemical is released. So because of these two chemicals, oxytocin and dopamine, you can actually develop a biological addiction. A biological addiction in the long run. Gaming addiction is based on these two chemicals, oxytocin and dopamine.